I came out to celebrate Día de los Muertos because it's my favorite holiday. I celebrate it every year. I've been celebrating it for over 10 years. The celebration itself is over 3,000 years old. It's pre-Columbian. It's the indigenous people of Mexico celebrating their ancestors and honoring them during this time of the year. And having gone back, being of Mexican descent, having gone back during this time and seeing the altars being built, like the one that's behind me, I think it's really beautiful that we honor our loved ones who have passed away. Just remembering everything about them and putting out their favorite food, their clothes, water for them, because it is a day when they come from the underworld or from another world to visit us.
This is Luz Aguirre, who's the program manager at Mano a Mano, and we have the honor of being here with Winnie Varghese, who is the priest in charge at St. Mark's Church in the Bowery, and we're standing in the beautiful East Churchyard. Most appropriately, it's actually a graveyard with many notable New Yorkers. And now one of New York's newest immigrant communities is creating a traditional celebration of the Day of the Dead in this churchyard of this very venerable institution. This year, the main altar is focusing on the historical heroes of the Mexican War of Independence and Revolution. And we have three invitational altars by artists here that treat specific social justice themes. We have an altar for those who are victims of drug trafficking in Mexico, an altar for the women who have died along the border in Ciudad Juarez, in that area. And we have an altar for children who have died, Los Angelitos.
This is the altar that is in memory of the victims into drug trafficking in Mexico that lately it's being in the news. You know, we're going through a really rough time. One of the reasons because I'm doing this altar is because I want to give them a moment of dignity and a place where I'm looking at the victims not as a number, not as bloody images, but I'm thinking about them as people, you know, as those who left by ignorance or desperate for trying to find and make a living, trying to support their families, and they couldn't find any other opportunity. It's sort of like a hybrid of a modern art installation with, you know, with part of the traditional Mexican, you know, culture. I think bringing the traditions to the new Mexican American generations is very important for us to recover the identity and to get rid of the stereotype as illegal immigrants and get rid of the stereotypes as criminals or drug traffic or drug dealers, whatever. But we have to let them know how beautiful the country is, and we can bring it to America and share it, you know. And there's so much more to learn about it. We're here in this country trying to make a living, but at the same time, we have so much to share with another, you know, countries, with another people, and we want to find a place of, you know, being part of this society.